Hello, everyone. For the past 4 months, I have been dealing with a child. A child by the name of Brian. Little baby Brian, aka Rice Gum, reached out to me back in 2018. Well, he tried to reach out to me. I wasn't following him, so I saw it on Drama Alert. He wanted to do a boxing match.
Down, if he's down, we'll make it happen. If not, then he's a pussy.
Fast forward to present day, June 2021, not completely present, but this year, Rice Gum reaches out to my wife, my precious wife. And you know what he says? He says that iDubbbz is irrelevant and that he's fallen off. Get him to box me. So I'm like, shit, man, what if I do due to that? So Anissa and I talked about it and she said, oh, that's a great idea. You should actually box him. And I was like, oh, okay, let's do it. I've been battling people mentally for years, and I think it's a good idea to put my neck out there, risk getting punched in the face a few times for more entertainment. So I responded to Rice. I said, yeah, let's do it. Are you serious about it? He seemed very serious about it, though he did want Keemstar to organize the event. So naturally, I took on all the responsibility of organizing this event because I'm not gonna have Keemstar do that. For the past 4 months, I have been grinding nonstop. I have been flying to LA, Las Vegas, having meetings over Zoom, meeting up with boxing managers, boxing promoters, looking at venues. I even went and got LASIK eye surgery. That was my brand, wearing the glasses. I got LASIK eye surgery so my contacts don't roll to the back of my head when I inevitably get punched in the face. Finally, after 4 months of searching, I find a guy who can set up a bomb-ass event. The boxing promoter and I reach out to Rice Gum and we say, we're ready. We're ready to set up this event. And what does Rice Gum do? He ghosts the boxing promoter repeatedly. He ghosts me repeatedly. And then when I finally am able to contact him, he says things like, oh, my neck is sore. Okay, what? From playing Fortnite? Why is your neck sore? And why do I give a shit if your neck is sore? He's talking about how it's not enough money. And I'm like, what do you mean not enough money? He wants like $1 million+. And I'm like, Rice Gum, you're a gangly loser that has zero boxing experience. And you're not even very famous. Why the fuck do you think any network is going to pay you $1 million+ to fight? You don't even have other talents. There's no reason to ask for $1 million. I'm getting a little off topic. Rice Gum was going to earn more than anyone else, okay? I'm not taking a salary on this boxing event. My earnings are going to pay all the other fighters and for charity, okay? So Rice Gum would be earning the most, hands down, yet he's still wimping out. I'm trying to tell him all the upside. I'm like, dude, you could sell merch. You can turn me into the alien from Family Guy, getting knocked out on the front of a t-shirt. You could sell that and make a lot of revenue. But he's so focused on getting money for like just existing. And it's like, you don't make money from just existing. You actually have to do the tiniest bit of work to leverage it. And who knows, maybe if you win, you'll make even more money. Think about the opportunities. You can then fight Jake Paul, beat him, then fight Logan Paul. Think about all the opportunities there are. Ricey Poo, Rice Chump. The other excuse that he used is that there wasn't enough hype. And I'm like, what do you mean not enough hype? That no, we're not talking about the fight. Of course there's no hype around it. And he also probably should have thought about that before contacting me again in June of 2021. Why are you DMing my wife if you don't actually want to fight? That seems like a pretty, like a serious inquiry, don't you think? So this is pretty much my last attempt reasoning with Rice Gum. You're earning more money than anyone else on the card. My money's going to charity, so I'm like, it's a good cause. It's going to be a hella amazing event. It's nostalgic. It's kind of weird. I don't think anyone would expect you and I to fight, which would be super fascinating. And four, it's an even match. We're both 6'1" or 6'2", and we both weigh about the same. So it'll be pretty fair and interesting. It's not going to be like that New Main versus Blueface fight where it's like a little midget facing off against a like the longest, lankiest giant in the world. I want it to be a good event, and I want the person I'm fighting to be at least, like, I want it to make sense. You know what I mean? either a really big influencer who's just going to bring in a lot of people, or a nemesis, right? Like a nemesis for me is obviously Rice Gum. Another nemesis who was going to be the backup, Keemstar, when I reached out to him saying, hey, would you replace Rice Gum? What did he say? The only person I'd fight is Ethan. I don't think Keemstar's at all confident that he can fight and beat me. And that's fair. He's like 5'6" or something like that. If you guys have any other influencers in mind that wouldn't wimp out on a boxing match, I am so beyond down. I don't care how big and strong they are. I don't care how athletic they are. I don't care how short or tall they are. I'll fight Dr. Disrespect. I don't care. I'll break his little scrawny legs in half. He will get absolutely destroyed by me. Let me know. I want to hear in the comments. I want to know what you think would happen in a fight versus me and Rice Gum, because like I'm sad. I'm very sad because I want the event to happen. I've spent a lot of time doing it. And Rice Gum is just fucking, like, not being cooperative at all. And it sucks. Ass. All right, guys. Thank you for hearing me out. I'll hopefully have an update soon. Maybe I'll talk about, if this Rice Gum thing doesn't work out, I'll make fun of him some more and also talk about the people who will be potentially replacing him. That would be ideal.